Let us continue. Our next speaker is Vladimir Golubyatnikov from Novosibirsk Sobolev Institute of Mathematics. Please.
First of all, I would like to emphasize that most of participants who are not from St. Petersburg are very grateful for organizers for such a nice conference. And one of my close friends who has graduated Leningrad State University, this is Yasha Ilyashberg, who works now at Stanford, wrote me that what a pity that I cannot present here at such an event, because I respect Olga Alexandrovna very much. So 3 years ago, at another conference in St. Petersburg, I gave a talk concerning detection of periodic trajectories, cycles in phase portraits of dynamical systems, which are considered as models of some biochemical processes. So the main interest for biologists, and especially for mathematicians, how many cycles do exist in the phase portrait? And if there are stable cycles, unstable, and so the geometry of phase portrait is very interesting. For example, a Hilbert 16th problem is one nice example of this. And biologists are also very interested in periodicity of our functioning of our organisms. So now in this talk, I will speak about construction of invariant surfaces in this phase portrait. So this is ensembles of trajectories. And dynamical systems which do appear here usually are composed by schemes of interaction of components of some molecular genetic systems. So the arrows show positive feedbacks. These letters like T denote negative feedbacks in construct. So this is a very famous example. So very famous, but very simple example. F0 is a monotonically decreasing function of a special type. And in equations which will be considered below, positive feedbacks will be described by actually by step increasing monotonic step functions, and negative feedbacks will be described by decreasing step functions. Though smooth cases will be also mentioned, but we shall consider basically this. This case, then, this is analytical description of all what happens here. 2 years ago, in one nice publication in very famous biological journals, we have considered just three-dimensional system. L1, L2, L3 are monotonically decreasing step functions. The variables are concentrations of the components. So these are non-negative variables. All coefficients are positive, all functions are non-negative. These negative terms show the natural degradation of the biological components in the system. And positive summons denote the rate of velocity of the synthesis of these components. The total balance, what is the derivative of concentrations? So how many was synthesis? The income is synthesis and the outcome is degradation. Now, the first geometrical construction here appears not in a three-dimensional, but in any dimensional. We compose an invariant domain, a bounded invariant domain, such that any cycle of this system should be contained in this domain, and the construction is rather easy. We assume that all these A1, A2, etc. are greater than one. Just a few slides below, I will explain physical meaning of this. assumption. And the point with unit coordinates is contained in this invariant domain, and we draw the planes parallel to this hyperplanes, which subdivide this invariant domain to 2 in the power n smaller parallelepipeds. We will call them just blocks, and in each block, the equations for the step function, the equations seem very simply, and the solution of any Cauchy problem is also so can be derived just by one line. Well, so we assume that the maximal values of these step functions are represented as follows, and that all these aj are greater than one. What does it mean? Now, the blocks are enumerated by binary multi-indices. Write epsilon 1 is 0 if the first coordinate is less than 1, less or equal. And if this coordinate is greater than 1, we write here 1. So we obtain the Boolean cube. So this is the point 1, 1, 1. What does it mean 0, 0, 1? With respect to first two coordinates, this block is closer to the origin, and with respect to the third coordinate, this point is point E is closer to the origin than the block. And it happens so that if you will start the trajectory of this dynamical system in this block, then it will be pass from block to block according to this diagram because of monotonicity of the functions in the right hand side sides of this equation. Now, just in any dimension, the following lemma holds again because of monotonicity of the functions in the right hand sides. For any pair of incident blocks, their common n minus one dimensional plane. So the points of this common face. So the trajectories of this point pass all trajectories pass either from the first block to the second one, or all trajectories pass from the second block to the first one. So we can draw oriented graph on this Boolean cube, which represents this decomposition. Now, just a short movie. We start trajectory here on this red face. Then each trajectory from this face, each for its own time, passes through from this face to this. Now I painted it in red. Again, each trajectory for its own time. Next step along that diagram, which was mentioned above, all trajectories from this phase pass to this horizontal phase. The next step, all these trajectories pass to this phase. And after 6 steps along the diagram, all points of this phase return to this phase again. And this is actually Poincaré map of the if the point returns to its initial position, this is a cycle, its trajectory is a cycle. Now, what will be considered below? I shall explain how have we proved that for the step function, there is just one non trivial fixed point of Poincaré map. The trivial point is this one, it remains at the same place at any of these 6 steps. Well, so 4 years ago, we have in the company of my PhD student, she was just a student at that moment, Lily Minushkin, and my colleague Vladimir Ivanov, we have proved that if this inequality holds, that means that degradation rates are stronger than the rate of the synthesis is stronger than the rate of degradation. So in this case, this three-dimensional system has exactly one cycle, And it's, this cycle is exponentially stable. Just a few words about the proof. So we consider all this transition from the phase to phase, the composition is from Carré map. And because of simplicity of this right-hand side, there are explicit, so you start y0, z0 is the coordinates of the initial point, then on the next phase, the coordinates can be represented as follows. Next step from the phase F1 to the phase 2, the formulas are as follows. And actually in numerical experiments, we substitute these results to the next, etc. But in qualitative studies of trajectories, we should consider some other way. So 4 years ago, we have noticed in our those two publications that Poincaré map has the monotonicity property. I will not explain what happens here. I just show you on the picture. So if you will consider the coordinates, this coordinate system such that the phase is contained in positive quadrant, then we can introduce here partial order. The point U is greater than point Z because its core, both its coordinates are greater than coordinates of the point zeta. Now, the lemma two claims that if coordinates of the point U are greater than coordinates of point zeta, then the coordinates of the images under the Poincaré mapping have the same order, the point coordinates of the image are greater than coordinates of the image of the point zeta. This is lemma two. Actually, this point S and point U are not comparable, so we nothing can be stated here. The lemma three, if point P is close to the origin, then its image is greater than the point P. And some analytical calculations show that derivatives with respect to these coordinates, derivative of the coordinate functions of Poincaré mappings. First derivatives are positive and second derivative are negative. So these derivatives are positive, then we can apply Frobenius-Perron theorem to the Jacobian matrix of this of Poincaré map. And these coordinate functions are convex. And this helps us to show uniqueness and stability of the cycle. Now, if you will take the point P, the opposite to the point E, its image is inside this phase, the image of its image is less with respect to that partial order, et cetera, and it, these points tend to the opposite angle, but this point is repellent. Thus, this sequence has maybe not unique, not unique limit, but due to convexity of the coordinate function, this due to this this limit is unique, and thus we show that. There are just two fixed points for Poincaré mapping, this angle point E and this unique limit point, which should be contained in the cycle. Now, some estimates of the Jacobian matrices in both these points. Both eigenvalues of Jacobian matrix here are less than one. Thus, this cycle is exponentially stable, and here the determinant of the Jacobian matrix at that point equals one. Thus, one of the so here Frobenius-Perron theorem implies this inequality, and then we have used. It was just occasionally I have found in a nice book of Philip Hartmann the following lemma. So if this point is a kind hyperbolic, then this Poincaré mapping can be linearized here. And this, since the Poincaré mapping here can be linearized, we can construct a step-by-step invariant surface, which a monotonic line, which is invariant with respect to Poincaré mapping. And the points of this monotonic line, trajectories of this point compose an invariant surface in the phase portrait. So then if you will start not far from this point E, we can compose in other invariant surfaces, which also generate invariant lines, which generate invariant surfaces in the phase portrait. And so we get foliation composed, but what is important here, these foliations are not smooth, because Grubben-Hartmann-Therrien claims that there is continuous change of the variables, not smooth one. So all this phase portrait, which we consider composed by the blocks, where which was mentioned in the diagram above. And this foliation actually has singularity. All the leaves of this foliation contain this cycle C, which passes through the limit point P infinity. Something similar happens in a smooth dynamical system of this kind, but we have seen in numerical experiments monotonicity of Poincaré mapping, but this is just numerical experiments. We have not proved something similar for smooth system. Now all these considerations can be extended to higher dimensional dynamical system considered by in some previous publications of other authors. The analog of the diagram is here. So these eight blocks contain if the synthesis is stronger than degradation, then in this four-dimensional case, we can we find that the cycle is unique and is exponentially stable. So there are the formulas which can be used in numerical experiments. So here is Poincaré map from block to block as in three-dimensional case. And again, the first derivatives are positive. The second derivative of the coordinate functions of the Poincaré mapping, second derivative are negative. And actually, for these pictures show that there is unique point such that the coordinate functions of the image and the coordinate function of initial point, has a unique solution. It's possible to get estimates of the Jacobian matrix at that unique non-trivial fixed point. And again, we can construct foliation with the following assumptions. If none of the moduli of eigenvalues of Jacobian matrix at the point E equals one, that means that this point is hyperbolic, then this foliation can be constructed. And this assumption is, I don't know still if it is essential, but positive matrices of three times three it can happen that one of them, eigenvalues equals one, so we should take care here. Most of the publication I will list them below are done sometimes in cooperation with biologists. Biologists sometimes under their influence, and it's very difficult to collaborate with them. They always ask, and what about numerical experiments? So it's not sufficient to prove a theorem, it's necessary. And actually they are right, because this is just the first step computerization of biological studies. The price of biological experiments grows exponentially, and the biologists before the manipulation with DNA, etc., try to simulate this on computers. And so numerical experiments of this kind are very useful for them. So Andrei Alexandrovich Akinshin, who is now is here with us, composed the cloud resource. The address of this resource will be on the next slide. So we can regulate the values of parameters of this system. Here I see only 19 trajectories. So we can imagine that they can use the surface spanned on the cycle here. Here is this is the address of this cloud resource. So you see we can regulate by means of these buttons the values of the coefficients. Again, maybe you remember that yesterday and on Sunday I was in a hurry from the lunch because we discussed all this with Andrei. But in the previous, previously, then we have considered something similar for smooth system. So again, there are five trajectories, and you can see. There is really invariant surface in the phase portrait. The idea that the cycles should be contained in invariant surfaces appeared maybe 20 years ago. So this is one of the first experiments which the picture appeared on my. So I was at that. Monitor this experiment with Kaplan's, and you can imagine that there is some surfaces, and here in this part the surface, nice surface of this form should appear. There are some other experiments which at that time we know. Except this one, you see this in these cases, the trajectories were piecewise linear, so the surface was composed easily. Again, the presence of invariant surfaces is very useful. Well, you see here, you can see the slow variables surface, and it's very important in interpretation of numerical experiments. Well, what about our future plans? Actually, we have used only reaction studies, only reactions in the system. But in the frame of any biological cell, the diffusion also happens, and thus the so C1, C2, C3 are concentrations. X1, XYZ are geometrical coordinates in the cell. And so what the first approach that the constant solution here gives an equilibrium, but what happens in so if this equilibrium is stable or unstable, so we start this studies just this year. So what are our future tasks? For me, they are related to the 16th Hilbert problem. So how many cycles and what is the mutual position here? The green color shows the traces of our communication with biologists. So this is biological journal. This is also biological journal. And then we also publications in mathematical journal, but one of my close friends and colleague, Volody Ivanov, recently passed away, and in his posthumous publication, he was very refined and mathematicians. He did not like applications, only functional analysis in finite dimensional spaces, but I am very proud that he was became interested in our studies, and here is the first lines of his paper, which will appear posthumous paper, which will appear in a few weeks. So the statement of the problem is very elementary, but there are so many interesting mathematical questions which appear here. So, and I think that this is the best time to stop. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, please, questions or comments in the room. And
may I ask a question?
Surely.
May I ask a question? So, Volodya, what is biological meaning of these cycles? I mean, is it something that is repeated from generation to generation, or what?
Just on the level of a single cell or single organism, because it's very important for us to have a lunch, to dream, to drink, and 20 hours later, this something the same. Once Alexander Sergeyevich Mishenko asked me, but the cell, the organism cannot exist infinitely. But this, surely this is just some approximation of our everyday life. Sometimes, so this cycle is just a mathematical model of some quasi-stationary process.
Thanks, it's clear.
Okay, more questions? Okay, let's thank the speaker again.